Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Civil Engineering Academy. My name's Cody. Let's go ahead and get started. So today we have a borrow pit problem, and we're wanting to find the volume of this borrow pit. So here's the question. It says a borrow pit with vertical sides and a rectangular plan view is 2 stations wide and 7 stations long. The depth slopes uniformly in the long direction, starting at 10 feet and ending at 40 feet. Most nearly, what is the volume of the borrow pit? And then it gives us answers there in cubic yards. And so we know that we're going to have to convert from feet to yards eventually. And so with that in mind, let's go ahead and get started. So there's really 2 ways that you can address that. So before we get carried away, you can find this stuff in the FE book, the FE manual on page 308. And in the PE, it's going to be in section 2.1.2 or page 49. Whichever you prefer, it's going to take you to the same place. So method one, there's 2 different methods that you can use here, and I'm going to show you both of them. So method one, draw a picture. That's always my go-to whenever I need to figure out a problem. I draw a picture. So we know this side's 10 feet. We know this side's 40 feet, and we know this up here is 700 feet. Boom. And if you don't remember, 1 station is 100 feet. So that's something that you need to remember. They'll expect you to know that on the exam. So we're going to split this into 2 different areas. So this is going to be area 1. This is going to be area 2. So area 1 is equal to 10 feet times 700 feet, and that gives you 7,000 square feet. As far as area 2 goes, it's going to be 40 feet minus 10 feet times 700 feet times a half, because it's a triangle. And that gives you 10,500 square feet. So this guy is the upper one, and this is the lower one. So we need to add those two together. So A1 plus A2 equals 17,500 square feet. So now to find the volume, we need to find the volume here. We're going to go 17,500 square feet, and we're going to multiply that by 200 feet wide. Okay, and that's going to give you an answer of about 3.5 million cubic feet. Okay, so now we need to convert that to cubic yards. And to do that, we understand that there are 27 cubic feet in a cubic yard, 3 times 3 times 3. So with that in mind, we're going to be looking at about 129,629.63 cubic yards. And that looks an awful lot like 130,000 cubic yards. And that is going to be answer B. Okay. So now for the second method. We're going to go ahead and scroll down a little bit. For method two, we're going to be using the formula in the FE and the PE handbook. So that is V equals A1 plus A2 over 2 times your length. And so if we're going to do that, we're going to end up with 10 feet times 200 feet plus 40 feet times 200 feet. And you may be wondering why I'm doing it the way that I'm doing it right now. I'll explain here in a minute. That's feet. Got carried away. 2 times our length of 700 feet. Okay. Good stuff. So the reason why I did this is because in method 1 we took the cross sections at the side. They're sides up. So if you're looking at it long ways, let's see, we'll draw a plan view here. We'll draw a plan view right here. In method 1, we were looking at it from this way. Well, now we're looking at it from this way. So this right here is 700, and this right here is 200. Okay. So if you plug that into your calculator, your volume ends up being 3.5 million cubic feet. And if you convert that, guess what? 130,000 cubic yards. So as you can see, you know, you can use logic, you can use the formula. Whenever it comes down to these pretty simple problems, you know, whatever you're comfortable with, whenever you're taking the test, that's what you need to go with. So I hope this video helps, and we'll catch you next time.